ஹலோ எவ்ரிவன், திஸ் இஸ் மேகலா, அசிஸ்டன்ட் ப்ரொஃபஸர், டிபார்ட்மெண்ட் ஆஃப் மேத்தமெட்டிக்ஸ், காமராஜ் காலேஜ் ஆஃப் இன்ஜினியரிங் டெக்னாலஜி, விருதுநகர், மதுரை டிஸ்ட்ரிக்ட். ஐ வெல்கம் யூ ஆல் டு திஸ் வீடியோ ஆன் பிஜி அண்ட் ஹோல்ட் பிரின்சிபல். திஸ் பிஜி அண்ட் ஹோல்ட் பிரின்சிபல் ஹேஸ் வாஸ்ட் அப்ளிகேஷன்ஸ் இன் மெனி இன்ஜினியரிங் ஃபீல்ட்ஸ் அஸ் வெல் அஸ் இன் ரியல் லைஃப். மெயின்லி இட் இஸ் யூஸ்ஃபுல் டு ஐடென்டிஃபை த சிச்சுவேஷன்ஸ் வேர் சர்டன் இன்புட்ஸ் லீட்ஸ் டு repetitions or collisions, and it is guiding the computer engineers while designing the computer algorithms for refining the algorithms for optimal performance. So it is mainly useful for designing computer algorithms. Okay, now let's see what is pigeonhole principle. Actually, pigeonhole principle is nothing but if n plus 1 pigeons occupy n holes, then at least one of the holes has more than one pigeon. It means that if the number of pigeons is more than the number of pigeon holes, then quite obviously one of the pigeon holes must contain more than one pigeon. Okay, now this principle can be generalized like this. Suppose we consider m as the number of pigeons and n as the number of pigeon holes, and definitely this m must be greater than n. Then at least one hole has more than integral part of, see it is quite important, integral part of m minus 1 by n plus 1 pigeon. So what I mean by this integral part means, while you are evaluating this value, you have to consider only the integral part and you have to ignore the decimal part. That's what this symbol means, integral part of m minus 1 by n plus 1 pigeon. Okay, now let's see some of the problems based on real life applications of pigeonhole principle. See, the first problem is, show that among 100 people, at least 9 of them were born in the same month. So here you are given with 100 people and it is asked to prove that 9 of the people were born in the same month. See, actually what you have to do is, we have to make use of the generalized pigeonhole principle to prove that 9 of them were born in the same month. For that, as I told you already, the number of pigeons must be greater than the number of pigeon holes. So here the larger data given is number of people, and the smaller data given is, it is not at all given, but it is understood because only there are 12 months. So even though the smaller data, that is number of pigeon holes, we have to consider the smaller data as number of pigeon holes, which is n, but it is not given with, but it is understood that there are only 12 months. So we have to consider this bigger data, which is given in the problem as number of pigeons, which should be noted by m, and it is nothing but number of people, that is 100 people. It should be considered as number of pigeons and it is noted by m. And the number of smaller data, even though it is not given with, we have to take that number of months, which should be considered as number of holes, so which is denoted by n, and which is equal to number of months, and it is 12. So the larger data, 100, is number of pigeons, which is m, and the smaller data is number of months, which is n, which is 12. Okay, now we are going to make use of the generalized principle. Then by the generalized pigeonhole principle, m minus 1 by n plus 1 people were born on the same month, isn't it? By that formula, what is that? Integral part of m minus 1 by n plus 1 people were born on the same month. Okay, so let's substitute the value of m and n to prove this result. Listen, so what is m here? M is 100. It is given with m is 100 and minus 1, and n we have taken as 12 months. So 100 minus 1 by 12 plus 1. Here it is integral part. No, so what is 100 minus 1? 100 minus 1 is 99. So 99 by 12, integral part of 99 by 12 plus 1. Okay, 99 plus 1. So what is 99 by 12? So 8 12s are 96. We'll get 8.25 plus 1. As I told you, we have to consider only the integral part and not the decimal part. Here we have to consider only 8. So what is that? 8 plus 1. Equal to 9. Integral part of this one is only 8. So 8 plus 1 is 9. Got it? So 99 by 12 is nothing but 8.25, but we have to consider only the integral part and we have to ignore the decimal part. So the answer is 8 plus 1 is, which is equal to 9. Okay, so then by a generalized pigeonhole principle, we have proved that among 100 people, 9 people were born in the same month. Okay, now let's move to the next problem. Here it is asked to show that 7 colors are used to paint 50 bicycles
at least 5 bicycles will be of the same color. So here also we are given with a bigger data, which is the bigger data, 50 bicycles, which should be considered as number of PGNs, that is M. Okay, and then smaller data also we are given. What is the smaller data we are given with this? We are given with number of colors, which is 7, which should be considered as N. Okay, and then we are supposed to prove that 8 bicycles will be of the same color. By making use of generalized principle, pigeonhole principle, we have to prove that 8 bicycles will be of the same color when there are 50 bicycles and they have to be colored with 7 colors. Okay, now as I told you, we have to consider the larger data as number of pigeons and it is denoted by M. So number of pigeon is equal to N, which is equal to number of bicycles, which is given as 50. And then what is the small data we are given with? Number of colors, that is number of holes, which is equal to N, which is nothing but number of colors, it is 7. So we have got M and N, which is given. We are given with M and N, which is 50 and 7. Now then by generalized pigeonhole principle, we know that at least M minus 1 by integral part of, that is quite important, integral part of M minus 1 by N plus 1 will be of same color. Okay, now let us substitute what is M and what is N. So here M is nothing but 50 and minus 1 by N is nothing but 7, 50 bicycles and 7 colors. So 50 minus 1, what is 50 minus 1? That is 49 minus 7. This is integral part plus 1, plus 1. So what is 49 by 7? It is nothing but 7 plus 1. Here we are not getting any decimal point. So we have to, anyway, we have to consider only the integral part. So we are getting only here the integral part, which is 7. So 7 plus 1 is 8. Hence we proved that among 50 bicycles, 80 bicycles will be of the same color by making use of the generalized principle, pigeonhole principle. Okay. Okay. Now let's see one more example, which is of different category. Here, see, you can find out the from the problem that we are supposed to find out the minimum number of students need to guarantee that 5 of them belong to the same subject having major as English, Max, Physics and Chemistry. Here you can notice that you are not given with a larger data, that is number of PGNs, which is M. It is not given, but you are supposed to find out the number of students. And you are given with a smaller data. What is that smaller data? Number of subjects. What are they? English, Max, Physics and Chemistry. So that there are 4 subjects. So the smaller data is number of PGN holes, which should be denoted by N, and it is 4. But we are not given with the larger data. So in this case, we are supposed to find out the M. Okay, so as usual, we have to consider the larger data, which is given as number of students. So number of PGNs equal to M equal to number of students. We are not given this, so let it be as M. And then number of holes is equal to N, which is number of subjects. So what are the number of 4 subjects we are given with, which should be considered as N. Smaller data is 4, larger data we are not given with, let it be M as it is. So now we are going to find out M by making use of generalized pigeonhole principle. What generalized pigeonhole principle says? Integral part of M minus 1 by N plus 1 people belong to the same subject. Okay, so then let us substitute N alone, as we don't have M. Okay, now M is not given, we are supposed to find out the number of students. So let it be M as it is. M minus 1 by what is N? 4 subjects. So 4 plus 1, it is given that at least 5. In the question itself, it is given that 5 people, we have to guarantee 5 people belong to the same subject. So in the question itself, we are given that 5 people should guarantee that they belong to the same subject. So we are given with the answer also. So we are supposed to find out M from the data. Okay, so how to find M from the data? So M minus 1 by 4 plus 1 equal to 5. Then we have to take LCM in this. So how will you take LCM? So M minus 1, this 4 should be taken as, should be taken as LCM. So it becomes M minus 1 plus 4 by 4 equal to 5. Okay, then what is M minus 1 plus 1? Now what will you get? M minus M plus 3. Okay, so you will get M plus 3 by 4, which is equal to 5. So if you bring this this one here, so what happens? M plus 3, so M plus 3 take this 4 here, so 20. So what happens? M is equal to 20 minus 3, which is nothing but 17. Okay, so we can find out M, that is the data not given with number of students. So number of students is M, it is got by 17. From this formula we can find out remaining values we have given with N, and also 5 people will belong to the same subject. It is given in the question itself, 5 people will belong to the same subject. So we are given with the answer, we are given with number of subjects, and we are not given with the number of students. So by making use of the generalized pigeon rule principle, we can find out what is M. So we have to substitute N alone and we have to take LCM. So when you take LCM, M minus 1 plus 4, 1 by 4, and you take 4 this side, so it becomes 20. So we will get M as 17. So got it? So therefore, total number of students is 17 to guarantee that at least 5 of them will belong to the same subject. So let's see one more problem based on this category. Here also, what is the maximum number of students required in a discrete mathematics class to be sure that at least 6. So the number which comes after at least 6 will be the answer. So we are given with at least 6 people will receive the same grade. So we are given with the answer also, and you are asked to find out number of students to guarantee at least 6 people will receive the same grade. What about the grades? There are 5 grades, A, B, C, D and E. So you are given with the smaller data and you are given with the answer at least 6, and you are supposed to find out the number of students to guarantee that 6 people will receive the same grade. For this also, we will make use of generalized pigeon rule principle. So now let us consider, as usual, number of the larger data is number of pigeons which is not given with. So number of pigeons equal to number of students equal to M, and then the number of holes which is smaller data is N, which is given with number of grades, nothing but 5. So we are given with the smaller data and we are supposed to find out the larger data. So then by generalized pigeon rule principle, at least 7 minus integral part of 7 minus 1 by N plus 1 people will receive the same grade. So let's find out what is M. See, let's substitute N alone because we are not given with M. So M minus 1 by 5 plus 1 equal to 6. So we have to find out what is M. Here also we have to take LCM. So 5 is LCM here. So M minus 1 plus 5 divided by 5 equal to 6. So you have to take this 5 this side. So what happens? Here 5 minus 1 is 4. So M plus 4 equal to 6 into 5 what? 30. Take this 5 this side, cross multiply. Then what is M? 30 minus, what is M? 30 minus 4, which is nothing but 26. So here I have given you some of the examples of real life applications of pigeon rule principle. I hope this video will be useful to you. Thanks for watching. Thank you.